Honourable members, please go ahead, honourable member.
Honourable Deputy Speaker, Your Excellencies President Zuma and Deputy President Ramaphosa, honourable members, fellow South Africans, I speak here on behalf of the Fraternity of Local Government, cognizant of the increased expectation by both local communities and the global development community of the role of the local arm of state in making a meaningful impact on development. Deputy Speaker, the past 2 years have been crucial in framing the future of our planet as the United Nations and the broader global development community have reached consensus on a number of international accords that shape what governments, multilateral agencies, business, NGOs, civil society, and other stakeholders should and could do in shaping the future of our Earth and indeed humanity. This is espoused in, amongst others, but not limited to, the Sustainable Development Goals, the Sendai Framework for Disaster Risk Reduction, the Paris Accord on Climate Change, the Addis Ababa Action Agenda, and recently adopted New Urban Agenda. As local government, under the auspices of the Global Task Force of Local and Regional Governments, an initiative to bring together the entire local government family globally, we have taken the view that these accords should be viewed and implemented as part of an integrated global development agenda. Honorable members, I introduce my input today reflecting on the global development agenda to draw to our attention our global commitments and obligations. Aware that this House adopted the National Development Plan as our lodestar as a country towards these objectives. In this regard, allow me to state the obvious. 2030 is a mere 13 years from now. It is in this 13 years from now that we have committed to the employment from 13 million in 2010 to 24 million in 2030, to raise income from 50,000 rands per person to 120,000 rands, to reduce poverty and inequality by raising employment, bolstering productivity and incomes, and broadening the social wage. Excuse me. To make high-speed broadband internet available to all at competitive prices, to realize food trade surplus, and to play a meaningful role in continental development, economic integration, and human rights, but to mention a few. It is thus that the NDP recognizes the building of a capable and developmental state as a crucial cog in the wheel to achieve the goals and targets that we have set ourselves. Aware of the reality that our local and regional governments could be the critical instrument, if not the pivot around which local development can take place, the African Union adopted the African Charter on the Values and Principles of Decentralization, Local Governance, and Local Development. The objectives of this charter include, amongst others, to promote resource mobilization and local economic development with a view of eradicating poverty in Africa, to promote the core values and principles of decentralization, local governance, and development, to promote the association and cooperation of local governments or local authorities at the local, national, regional, and continental level, and to promote civil society, private sector, and people participation in decentralization, local governance, and local development initiatives. Deputy Speaker, I highlight these noble objectives of the Charter only to remind the House of Article 23 of the Charter, which states, and I quote, "This Charter shall be open to all Member States of the Union for signature, ratification, or accession in conformity with their respective constitutional procedures," close quote. Deputy Speaker, I respectfully on behalf of the local government fraternity, request this House to put in place the necessary processes to meet the requirements of Article 23. Aware that we are still a few countries short from gaining the threshold for this charter to be in force, I respectfully urge that we further use both bilateral and multilateral engagements, including the Pan-African Parliament, to enable the achievement of a capable local sphere of the developmental state, not only in our country, but throughout the continent. Deputy Speaker, former President Nelson Mandela, in his address to the inaugural Conference of Organized Local Government in November 1996, said, and I quote, "You have the task of doing whatever is necessary to ensure that our new local government system serves the needs of our communities. You have the responsibility to make their voice heard and to provide an effective instrument for them to improve their lives," close quote. It is against this backdrop of the words of President Mandela that we want to respectfully request this House to, in order to achieve a state that is capable of playing a developmental and transformative role, ensure that all spheres of governments support local government as the sphere closest to the people and the implementation level of our enjoined government. The role of cities, given their importance as engines for economic growth and job creation in transforming the space economy and reversing our spatial legacy, is key. This comes with particular reflection on the powers and functions necessary to execute the mandate of why devolution and assignment is critical in the management of integrated spaces. In respect to exploring opportunities for stimulating rural development, local government can play a meaningful role in the implementation of effective and innovative.
Live visuals there coming from Parliament as the members of Parliament are debating the President's State of the Nation address that he delivered about a week ago that was marred with violence and insults. We do know that the economic freedom fighters have opted to stay out of this debate.